Morning Glory America. It's Hugh Hewitt. Evening Grace, if you're listening on tape delay or on our podcast. Joe said yesterday, oh, here it is. Everyone saw it. Cut number one. Play it.
We've heard, Zeke Emanuel, that nobody could have seen this coming. The fact is everybody saw this coming. Everybody saw this coming in early January. So I know you, like me.
Now, I'm going to spend the weekend, Dwayne is going to spend the weekend preparing a program for you, because this show, I am not making a vain statement. I am stating a fact. This show was first. We were frequent. We were adamant that this was a danger. And we did not start until January 21st. The Wall Street Journal was the first major article I read about it, and then I began to sound the alarm. Tom Cotton was early to the bell. Admiral Stavridis was early to the bell. Nobody else was.
I want to give you an update right now on the deadly coronavirus. At least 80 people in China have died from the virus, and nearly 3,000 have been infected with the illness, which is spreading globally. Now with five confirmed cases in the United States. The CDC says the cases have been reported in Washington, Chicago, California, and Arizona. Across China, 15 cities with a combined population of 57 million people have been placed on lockdown. Yet, according to Chinese media reports, about 5 million residents left Wuhan, the city at the center of the outbreak, before the lockdown began. So let's bring in Morning Joe medical contributor Dr. Dave Campbell for more on this. Your thoughts, Dr. Dave, on this, you know, explain the severe concern about this outbreak, and how worried should Americans be? Should they panic?
Good morning, Mika. No, Americans do not need to panic. The Chinese are already panicking, as they should, because this virus is spreading all through the central parts of China. And it's a new virus. It has never been seen before. So its mechanism of spreading is not quite known yet. What I would suggest, however, is that Americans take this as a wake-up call for seasonal flu. We are not out of the flu season. We've already had 15 million cases of the flu in the U.S., 140,000 hospitalizations. 54 children have died, almost as many as have died from the novel coronavirus. And everybody's not vaccinated yet. Even if you get vaccinated and get the flu, it lowers the complication rate from the flu. So we don't need to be overly concerned yet in the United States about the novel coronavirus. Right. We do need to keep our eyes open for the seasonal flu. We're right in the middle of the flu season still.
And that's not to point a finger. It's to stop the pointing of fingers. I'm going to point it out. I'm going to make a show, a special, next week to prove to you what we did in January and February to alarm and sound the alarm for everybody about coronavirus. And nobody else did it. Now, I have 3 hours a day, and I got Dwayne. So I've got resources that nobody else has. And we are going to prove it so that it will make other people, not just Joe, I like Joe, everybody shut up about pointing fingers.
People restricting what they did socially. This business leader I spoke with last night, he's got a global company, said, think about how it's going to impact you. If this continues, and the government's not talking straight, are you going to go on airplanes as much as usual? Are you going to go in movie theaters? Are you going to go, all of these events. And so we're talking about the supply chain that it's going to impact in China, but it's going to impact our daily lives here in America if this crisis continues, which will have a huge economic hit.
Nobody knew how bad it would get, with the exception, perhaps, of me and Tom Cotton and Admiral Stavridis. Nobody. But we knew because we were familiar with both PRC and the 1918-20 plague. And therefore, we were alarmed. And we're going to prove it. In the meantime, everyone else who was walking around town and going to sporting events and telling people to go out, and I'm not going to name names, just shut up about this, because history will not be kind to you. You cannot rewrite history. Impeachment did impact the ability for my show and the people like Tom Cotton and Admiral Stavridis to be heard. That's what it did. There were no questions. in the CBS News debate initiated by the panel about coronavirus. There was no mention in the NBC News debate about coronavirus. Nobody took it seriously until 2 weeks ago, and now we have 5,000 Americans dead.